Good morning, I'm Frank Coletta. Welcome to 10 News. It's now officially Australia's worst natural disaster.
It just came through from the north. It was just a huge, huge fireball.
More than 100 people are dead and entire communities wiped out in the Victoria fire tragedy.
You can't believe it.
Help is being sent from across the nation and around the world, and we're being warned to brace for more bad news.
It's the 70th anniversary of one of Australia's worst peacetime air crashes. In October 1938, the Kyeema smashed into the side of Mount Dandenong in Victoria, killing all 18 people on board, including a man many touted as a future Prime Minister, Charles Hawker.
Emergency workers secure Burnley Tunnel in Australia's second largest city of Melbourne after a multiple car and truck collision caused an explosion and fire. Three people died in the incident.
A span of the new Westgate Bridge in Melbourne collapsed today, killing at least 28 people and injuring many others. Rescue crews are digging under piles of twisted metal and wood to try and locate 21 men. This is Bob Wilcox in Melbourne reporting for ABC viewers in all Australian states. The Victorian Premier, Sir Henry Bolte, announced tonight that a royal commission will investigate the disaster.
25 years ago tomorrow, Victoria was hit by the Ash Wednesday bushfire disaster. In the second of our special reports, we join survivors from Melbourne's nearby hills who can never forget what happened.
House after house was gutted as the flames gathered strength.
The collision happened at 1:40 p.m. when the truck travelling north on the Murray Valley Highway veered too late and slammed into the second of three carriages. The train was split in two but careered on through the level crossing, leaving behind the detached third carriage and finally stopping 150 metres beyond the point of impact. Police from the victim's identification unit worked alongside the state emergency service, clearing bodies from the wreckage. Those on site described the task as gruesome and difficult.
Police say it appears the vehicle lost control on gravel and spun sideways before ending up on the other side of the road, giving the group no time to react.
The 100th anniversary of Victoria's worst rail disaster was marked today, with relatives of many of the victims helping to unveil a plaque at the crash site in Sunshine. It was there in 1908 that two trains packed with Easter holidaymakers collided. 44 people were killed and 500 injured. The memorial is engraved with the names of the dead and roses were placed in their honour.
The Black Friday fires leave death and destruction in their wake.
71 people died on the 13th. Over 1,000 homes were destroyed. The forestry industry was decimated. 69 or 70 sawmills in the forests were destroyed, which meant the livelihood of a large number of Australians were just wiped out.
Although the Forest Commission is soon created, the Country Fire Authority takes a few years and more tragedy to form. In 1944, fire again ripped through the Western District and Central Gippsland, claiming 51 lives.
The miners marched, taking up arms, to what was to become the Eureka Stockade. The early morning of Sunday, the 3rd of December, saw heavily armed soldiers and police attack the stockade. The fighting lasted less than an hour. 30 men were killed. Ballarat,
we'll be the savior,
the birthplace of
our land,
of the Australian spirit.
Now our faith will...
The gunman, a 19-year-old Clifton Hill man, moved
when
down...
When all hell broke loose on Hoddle
Street... Victoria has suffered the most appalling night of violence in its history.
The carnage and confusion of Hoddle Street as violence erupted just a few kilometres from the centre of the city late on a Sunday night.
The silence was broken by a volley of shots fired from this intersection. It was 9:37 on the 9th of August, 1987.
Seven people killed, 19 injured, as teenager Julian Knight, a failed army officer, took his anger to the street.
The SS Alert was moving wood chips and three passengers from eastern Victoria to Melbourne on a fateful night in 1893. Battered by waves, she sank, and of the 16 on board, just one survived.